Do you have a hard time falling asleep, often tossing and turning around in bed all night long? Do you find yourself waking up feeling tired even though you slept more than 8 hours? Is your sleep schedule so messed up that you barely ever see the sun? If you've answered yes to any of these questions, then you've come to the right place. Because this is the ultimate guide for fixing your sleep. All you gotta do is watch this video till the very end and follow the instructions by commenting down below, and you will be able to fix your sleep problems once and for all. Starting off, we have step number one, the target. First and foremost, you have to decide on the time that you will be waking up. Do not pick an extremely early time just because some guru told you to. You don't need to be waking up at 5 a.m. to succeed in life. You need to be waking up at a realistic time every day so that you'll actually stick to it. If you have work or class in the mornings, then waking up an hour or two before is good enough. And if you're someone who likes to hang out with others in the evening like me, and you don't usually head to bed until midnight, then waking up at 8 or even 9 a.m. is totally acceptable. You should not sacrifice your social life just to wake up early. I mean, I've been waking up at 10 a.m. for the past year, and it's been working out perfectly fine. Waking up anywhere from 6 to 11 a.m. are all good times that could work depending on your schedule. What's most important is that you wake up at around the same time every day. So figure out your ideal time and write it down in the comments down below. Our goal is for you to wake up every day at around this time without feeling tired. Which brings us to step number two, the setup. I want you to set an alarm right now so that you wake up at your ideal time tomorrow. Now, waking up to this alarm is probably going to be tough for those of you that have really messed up schedules, but you're just going to have to push through it. I promise that it's only going to be tough the first couple of times. If you follow all the instructions in this video, your body will eventually get used to waking up at this time after just a couple of days, and you will no longer even need an alarm. That's right, I don't use an alarm to wake up because alarms usually force you to wake up while you're in the middle of a sleep cycle, which causes you to feel extremely tired. Once you've set your alarms, add the words alarm set to your comment down below. Now let's move on to step number three, the morning reboot. Starting from tomorrow when you wake up, you're going to have to do two very important things. But first, let me take a quick detour and teach you about the circadian rhythm. The circadian rhythm is basically a fancy name for our body's internal clock. This clock regulates our sleep and wake cycles. It controls when we feel tired and when we feel energized, and it repeats roughly every 24 hours. Now, this clock is regulated by certain hormones that we naturally produce. For the purposes of this video, we're going to simplify things and focus on the two most important ones, cortisol and melatonin. The production of these two hormones tends to act in reverse of each other. When your cortisol levels go up, your melatonin levels go down. When your melatonin levels go up, your cortisol levels go down. Cortisol, most commonly known as the stress hormone, is responsible for feeling awake, which is why in healthy individuals with good sleep cycles, their levels of cortisol will spike in the morning and slowly taper off throughout the day. On the other hand, melatonin, most commonly known as the sleep hormone, is responsible for feeling tired. You need it to fall asleep and to stay asleep, which is why your body needs to start producing melatonin starting in the late afternoon and continuing all throughout the night. Now, like I mentioned before, there are two very important things that you have to do in the mornings after you wake up. The first is to figure out a way to expose yourself to some sunlight, because when sunlight reaches our eyes and our skin, our body starts producing more cortisol, which is the hormone you need to feel awake and energized. Now, this doesn't mean you have to run outside and bathe under the sun for an hour. Sunlight reflects off of almost every surface outside, so simply taking a brief walk or sitting down next to a window will allow you to reap most of its benefits. In fact, a study published in 2013 by the American Academy of Sleep Medicine compared office workers who sat next to the windows and office workers who did not. They found that on average, the office workers who sat next to windows had 173% more exposure to natural white light from the sun throughout the day, and because of this, they slept on average 46 minutes more each night. The reason they slept better at night is because sunlight causes our bodies to produce more serotonin, which is a precursor for melatonin. which means that if you get more sunlight in the morning, not only will it tell your body to release cortisol at the right time, but it will also allow your body to produce more melatonin at night, allowing you to fall asleep faster and sleep better. So figure out a way to get more sunlight exposure in the morning starting from tomorrow, and make sure to put your words in the form of an implementation intention. Basically, you write a statement in the format of when X happens, I will do Y. So for example, when I wake up, which is X, I will take a walk around the block, which is Y. 91% of people who use implementation intention end up doing the action that they write down. So figure that out and add it to your comment down below. The second thing you have to do in the mornings is some sort of exercise. Like we mentioned before, you want to figure out ways to produce more cortisol in the mornings, and exercise is perfect for this. Because when you put your body under intense stress of any kind, a ton of cortisol is released. A study was conducted in 2014 at the Appalachian State University by a professor Fairbrother. Researchers split a group of participants into three and had members of each group run on a treadmill for 30 minutes at 7 a.m., 1 p.m., and 7 p.m. They found that participants who worked out at 7 a.m. fell asleep faster, slept longer, and had a deeper sleep cycle as compared to the other groups. In fact, they spent up to 75% more time in the deep sleep stage at night, which is the stage that causes us to feel refreshed in the morning. Now, this doesn't mean that you have to wake up at 6:30 a.m. and go running. It just means that you should do some sort of exercise after you wake up. The exercise should range from moderate to hard intensity, and you should do it for at least 10 minutes in order to reap the benefits. So figure out a way to incorporate some sort of exercise into your mornings, and just like with the sunlight, use implementation intention to set up an appointment for tomorrow. For example, after I take a walk in the morning, which is X, I will do some jump rope exercises, which is Y, and add it to your comment down below. Now that we've created a plan to spike our cortisol levels in the morning, it's time for us to move on to step number four, which is the evening setup. Ideally, we want to naturally feel more tired as the evening comes around so that we can fall asleep easily, and the only way this is possible is if you do the following three things. If you can follow the instructions here, you should eventually be able to fall asleep within 10 to 15 minutes of going to bed. First, you must limit your caffeine consumption and only drink caffeinated products before noon. And this is because caffeine works by blocking adenosine receptors, which is a special chemical that our body naturally produces throughout the day that makes us feel sleepy. That's why a cup of coffee in the morning helps us feel awake, because it literally tricks our body into thinking that we are well rested. The problem with caffeine is that it has a half-life of 6 to 8 hours depending on your body chemistry, meaning that it takes 6 to 8 hours for half of it to leave your body. So if you drink a cup of coffee at, say, 4 p.m. and then you try to sleep at midnight, you probably still have half of the caffeine floating around in your body. And the more caffeine that you have in your body when you're about to go to sleep, the lower your quality of sleep will be. You end up spending less time in the deep sleep stage, causing you to wake up feeling even more tired, causing you to drink even more coffee. And the cycle goes on and on and on. If you're someone who drinks like 3 cups of coffee a day, I hate to break it to you, but you have an addiction. If you ever want to fix your sleep, you're going to have to limit your consumption. And personally, I rarely ever drink caffeinated products. The only thing my body needs in the mornings are those sweet, sweet sunlight rays. So if you're someone who indulges in caffeinated products, figure out what you're going to do and add it to the comments down below. For example, I will limit myself to just 1 cup of coffee every day in the mornings. The second thing you have to do in order to fall asleep easily is to control your lighting. When blue light, which is the same bright white light that's emitted in office buildings and from most of our devices, reaches our eyes, it prevents our bodies from producing melatonin because it's basically tricking our body into thinking that it's still the morning. Now, in a perfect world of perfect sleep, I would tell you to stay away from all light the moment the sun goes down. But let's be real, most of you are not going to stop using your devices at like 7 p.m. So the best alternative is to control the lighting in the rest of your house and your room. There are certain light bulbs that you can get that are blue light free. The light they produce feels similar to the lighting of candles, and this will help your body produce more melatonin in the evening. What I would recommend is that you get one of these for a lamp or something, and when the sun goes down, you can turn off your main lights in your room and turn on the candle lights. If you can find a smart bulb that dims, that's even better, because you can have it dim as the evening goes on. And if you can't do either, you could just turn off all your lights and use the light from outside, because technically, removing as much light as possible is the best thing to do. Also, make sure to install a blue light filter on your phone and other devices. I personally use Flux for my laptop and Twilight for my phone. If you do all of this, your body should start producing more melatonin the moment the sun goes down, which will cause you to naturally feel tired when bedtime comes around. So install those filters and figure out what you're going to do with the lighting in your room right now, and add another implementation intention to the comments down below. For example, when the sun goes down, which is X, I will turn off my main lights and turn on my lamp, which is Y. Now, it's important to mention that you should also black out your entire room as much as possible while you sleep, because even the slightest light that reaches your eyes will affect your melatonin production throughout the night. So go around your room and figure out a way to get rid of as many lights as possible before you head to bed. I personally unplug everything from the wall and even tape black garbage bags over some of my windows. But if you don't want to take it to such extreme levels, you could just use an eye mask. Which is why this episode was brought to you with the help of the guys at Manta Sleep, with their signature product, the Manta Sleep Mask. The Manta Sleep Mask allows you to 100% black out your eyes so that zero light from the outside environment reaches your eyes. This allows your body to experience more deep sleep, which will allow you to feel more rejuvenated in the mornings. The mask is adjustable. It fits your head with zero pressure on your eyelids and lashes, no matter what size you are. And it's made from soft, breathable, durable materials so that you'll practically forget that you're even wearing it when you go to sleep. You can also use it to nap throughout the day. Head on over to www.mantasleep.com and use coupon code PILL to get a 10% discount off of anything in their store. They actually have 6 different varieties that you can pick from suited to your needs. If you end up getting a mask, how do you plan on using it? Now, the third and final thing you have to do to fall asleep easily is to lower your body temperature. See, when our body is ready to sleep, there is an automatic drop in our core temperatures that helps initiate the process. Studies have found that the ideal room temperature for this actually lies around 60 to 68 degrees Fahrenheit, which translates into 15.5 to 20 degrees Celsius. Knowing this, you can do several things. You can turn on a fan or an air conditioner, which will help lower your body temperature. Or if you don't want to use so much electricity, you can opt to take a shower in the evening. Because after you take a shower, all of the water on you starts evaporating, which lowers your temperature. The ideal time to take a shower is around 2 hours before you plan on heading to bed. This technique is especially effective in hot climates and during the summer. So using this knowledge, let's create yet another implementation intention that you can stick to starting from tomorrow. For example, after I finish my dinner, which is X, I will take a shower, which is Y, and add it to your comment down below. Now that we've covered everything you need to do to start feeling sleepy, it's time for us to move on to the final step in this guide. Step number 5 is falling asleep. Now, if you followed all of the instructions in this video for a couple of days, then your internal clock should have adjusted itself and you should naturally start feeling very tired around your bedtime. When this happens, turn off all of your lights and head to bed. And there's only one thing you must keep in mind. Do not look at your phone or devices when you are in bed, because any light that you are exposed to here will make it harder for you to fall asleep, and it will also diminish the quality of your sleep. This can be tough for the first couple of days when your internal clock is being adjusted, but you must push through it. What you can do instead is listen to something like white noise, an audiobook, or even some YouTube videos to help you fall asleep. I personally listen to lore videos, interviews, and even podcasts, and it always works like a charm. In order to prevent yourself from having to look at your phone, simply set a playlist and have it start playing before you head to bed. Listening to something to fall asleep is actually optional, because some of you will feel so tired that you will fall asleep within minutes once you're tucked in. That is, if you follow all the instructions in this video. So please add, "I will not look at any screens while I'm in bed," to your comment down below. And that's it. If you follow all 5 of these steps, you should be able to fix your sleep. Please try it out and let me know if it actually worked, because this strategy has always worked for me whenever I travel and have to fix my sleep schedule. I hope this video was helpful, and besides that, guys, stay tuned.